My name is Alexander Matrunich. Greetings from Tallinn, Estonia. Today I would like to talk about a tool that allows our user to control access to their online data science products like Shiny applications or APIs. For this, I would like to present a package, backendlesser, and the package itself, it doesn't provide any infrastructure to keep credential and other private data of your users. Instead, the package relies on a cloud platform. It's called backendless, and so we delegate all these tricky questions on keeping this private data safe online. And useful thing about backendless that the service has a free plan where you can make your application, your Shiny or API, that could make up to 1 million calls to backendless API. So let's check how it works. Yeah, so functionality is very simple. We would like to register a user of our Shiny application. Then we want to allow user to log in, to log out, and we want to track balance of the account. Let's look at really simple Shiny example. So firstly, let's run it. Assume that we have the package installed, and there is a function Shiny demo login, and let's look at how it works. Yeah, so when it starts, you see basically only two controls here for user: login and register. So let's firstly try to register. Very typical form for registration. And after your user click register button, the underline R function will talk to backendless API and will send all this data to your backendless account, and your user will be created. Yeah, your user registration successful. And as additional note, you could activate on the backendless functionality that would require your new user to click a confirmation link in a email box, or for example, you could also have welcome email for a new user. Okay, so let's say our user was registered, and now our user wants to log in and to access some data service. Again, nothing criminal. So after login happened, interface slightly changed. Login and register buttons, they disappeared, and logout appeared. And here we see some interesting data science output. So how to install all these parts? The installation and the setup consists of two parts. Basically, we need to create an account on backendless platform, and then we need to install a package and provide credentials. So firstly, we go to backendless, register there an account, and register under our account. We create a new application, and Here you get application ID and API key. You create, you pass this this key, API ID and key through, for example, R environment file. I strongly wouldn't recommend you to keep keys or app ID in your R source code in a plain text area. But this is mostly for testing. When you run your application already online, probably you would like to have this application, for example, in form of Docker. And when you use Docker, you could rely, and you advise to rely on Docker Swarm secrets. So please check the documentation here if you're interested. Then we install the package. It's not on CRAN, so use remotes or dev tools for this purpose to install it from Git repository. Yeah, and now let's look at simple R code. So here I'm showing just two example, even without Shiny here, right? So we have a user name defined. Here we check that this user name is not used. We don't have such user with such name. Yeah. And if we don't have such user, then we can create, register a new user with given username and password. After you created, run this command in your backendless account, new user will appear. Yeah, as you see here. Then how we would or how your Shiny application would make a login of a user using this function, again user and password, and then we can check that this session is active. Then after some manipulations in your Shiny application or your API product, after this, your user would like to log out, and you use for this function, and then you can check that this user is actually log out. Then also we can remove the user if he or she asked you to. And here some details on how Shiny, how it could work in Shiny application. For in the very beginning, it's example of this very basic Shiny application, right? In the very beginning, the logout link and login user and plot, they're hidden and not shown by user. Our Shiny is waiting for event, and in this case, when your user click on a button on link login, when it happens, Shiny will show the element login mail. It's here, so it will jump. Yeah. From hidden to shown. There are some additional functionality in the package. For example, we have their counters. When you have some balance for your user, you can use counters to increase or decrease this balance, and also you can save any arbitrary data related to your user, and also keep it in your backendless on the backendless platform, so you don't need an additional database for storage for keeping this data. Of course, it's about only small amounts of data. There are some features on the backendless platform that are not implemented in the package. For example, logins through social networks. Users would probably, many users would like not to remember or keep one additional password, and they would like to log in through social networks. This is one possible improvement. Then password reset, automatic password reset is not implemented there. That could be the backendless platform supports it. And additionally, you can keep your log files of your application also in backendless, not to keep them in Docker, for example. And probably one of the most important questions is about security. I'm not a cyber security expert, and so likely the tools approaches used in the application in the package quite naive from security point of view. So this, if you are going to use this package for some critical security critical tasks, please check the package how it's implemented. Here you can find where you can find the source code and issue trackers tracker and the contact details of the author. Thank you very much. I hope you will find this package useful, and feel free to contact me in case of questions or any about improvements. Thank you very much.